Okay, hi, good afternoon everyone. It's me again, your speaker today, Calvin. So perhaps while waiting for more audience to join us, so let me just go through some of the comments first. So yes, hello everyone. Good afternoon to you all. So I hope that you all have a very great lunch, and then and also prepare yourself to have this session to learn something new today. So today we will have a new topic, and as usual, so we will have a quiz after this. Right. So today, promote water heater by Louis Kong. Oh yeah. So sadly to tell you that no, we are not talking about the water heater, but instead we are talking about an equipment to put on. Equipment to put on site, which if in fact is not heating up, but desuperheat. So what is desuperheat and desuperheat what? So yeah. Okay, so and then I have Tran who concerned about why my cannon today become so small. So this is actually another exciting part today, so which I will share with you guys later on at the end of this session. Right, so let us start with our session today. So yes, yeah. So I guess just in case if anyone of you don't really aware on what Turcomp BNB is having at the moment, is that for the month of November and December, so on every Monday to Tuesday, so 1:30 in the afternoon, we will have lunch meeting session. So for these 2 months, our topic will be more on the technical sharing, so with our committee and our audience. So for today, I'm glad that I can share another new thing with you guys. So which we call it as shown in the title. So the product that I can share today is about the superheater. So what is the superheater? So like I said just now, what is actually the superheat? And maybe some will ask what is superheat? So let me have a straw with you guys on maybe some basic fundamental on this. Okay. I'm not sure whether most of you still remember on the table on the water properties. Sorry, the property of H2O. So as you guys know, right, so for water when it's fall below zero degrees Celsius, so it will be solidified into ice, so which in solid form. So okay, so in well it is in ice form, so if you apply some heat on it, then it will start to melt. So and turn into water. So water is liquid form. So I guess you all know that so if you keep adding heat onto water, what it will turn into steam. So steam is considered as a gas form. So okay, steam or maybe vapor. So okay, as you can see from the figure that I show in here, so you can see on the first part, which means that the saturated water means that the H2O currently is in purely water form. So while you keep adding on the heat, so it will increase the temperature. So you will have the saturated water line. So at this stage, right, there is actually a mixture between water and steam. Why the temperature is stagnant at this place is that because the heat that you apply into it means that the energy that you apply to your water, so it actually uses that energy instead of increasing increasing the temperature. So it actually converts the energy into the latent heat. So they are slowly changing form from water to steam. So okay, as we all know, right? So once that the water reaches 100 degrees Celsius, so it will be so we call it as the boiling. So it will change to steam. So okay. You see, for our industrial applications, right, actually steam is something very useful. It's actually considered as the utility. So we can use steam to power turbine, and then we can use steam to power turbine, and then turbine can actually, for example, in power plant, turbine can actually generate the electricity. So but then you cannot just use the normal steam, which like you just boil your water in your home, because the energy is not sufficient enough to power up the, or maybe to turn the turbine. So we will need to use the superheater steam. Superheater steam is actually the steam, under the, when the water is under steam form, then you keep continuous applying heat or we call as the energy into it. So it will actually increase the enthalpy of the steam. So which means that you imagine that, so it's that you are actually pumping the energy into the steam so that they will have higher internal energy to, for our utility usage. So okay, the thing is after the steam has powered the turbine, so definitely we have to do something on it, because superheated steam is actually mean that you cannot just let it just maybe blow into the atmosphere, right? So definitely we will need to so while it's transferring into a pipeline, so we would need to use the product that we are going to talk today, which is the superheater, which in simple term is that is used to superheat the superheater steam. Means that to return to change the superheater steam into a lesser energy form so that we can recycle use, or maybe you can use it for another applications. So now that maybe you guys very blur on what I think that I'm talking right now, that's okay. So maybe for today we just focus on a few things. What is the superheater? So what the superheater actually function as? So yeah, so it will be all answered in the next video that I'm gonna share with you guys. Right. So for today, so the same as well, we will have my friend Mathieu to share us this presentation slides. So just in case you guys have any questions, so feel free to drop us a comment so we will be at the end of the show. So without any further ado, let's enjoy the slides.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the third and final meeting on Carraro product. So until now we spoke about regulator, now I will do a rapid presentation on our second main product, the Desuperheater. So what is a Desuperheater? It is a final control device which injects water into superheated steam to regulate downstream steam temperature. Here below we can see the schematic example with the superheated steam that receives the action of the water injection in the steam pipe and become the superheated steam. Here we can see some pictures of real desuperheaters. How does the superheater work? Cool water injected, shown in blue color, absorbs latent heat from the steam, shown in red color, causing the reduction of steam temperature through an isenthalpic process. In other words, thanks to the water vaporization. The superheater main applications are steam generators process, electric power station, pressure steam, low temperature process, LNG regasification terminal, that's a cryogenic application. Here we can see all the superheaters series with all the same function of the superheating the steam, but each one have specific different characteristic. We have the first one that is the variflow, that's a variable area multiple nozzle DS model. Varispring, that's a variable area DIM spring assisted model. Variboul, variable area MDM spring assisted and wall mounted model. Varifix, fixed nozzle DIF model. Varispry, fixed nozzle DA model for small steam pipe diameter up to 4 inch. Varivent, fixed area vortex Venturi model. Varicryo and Varifrigo for cryogenics application, that's our variable area multiple nozzle for LNG. Let's see in detail the first one, that is the Variflow. That's the first variable area desuperheater. It's a multiple nozzle desuperheater and is designed to combine excellent water atomization and high range ability, up to 1 to 50 depending on the selected nozzle. It offers a large variety of nozzle combinations in number and in sizes. in order to provide accurate control of steam temperature in whatever conditions. The superheater is equipped with actuator and positioned like a control valve. It allows to have a complete control of the water amount needed for the superheating process, and no auxiliary control valve is necessary. The setting temperature must be at least 7 degrees Celsius higher than saturation temperature to avoid the condensation of the steam. And the steam line size must be at least 6 inch, and max water capacity is 50 cubic meter per hour, and maximum rating is up to 2500. We have our standard actuator brand, but on request we can provide the superheater with the other actuator requested brands. Usually the actuator is a pneumatic, but upon request we can install other type, for example electric one, a special. And the same is for the positioner. Another option is supply the bar shaft body flow with actuator and positioner installation and setting at customer care. The body flow can be supplied with 6 or 9 nozzles. The nozzles are arranged in 2 or 3 columns with an overlapping arrangement to give a continuous change of uncovered discharge area within the strokes of the piston. In addition, the nozzles can be supplied with mixed capacities in order to provide flow characteristics that best fit the specific application. Here you can see the typical installation. Water amount passing through the superheater is determined by the steam temperature control loop, as shown in the above schematic. Here a real example of products with the main characteristic. The superheater regulated the temperature from 450 to 365 Celsius on a 20-inch steam pipe. Here another sample with regulation from 450 to 260 in a 8-inch steam pipe. Now let's start to see the second model, that is the Vary spring. It is a variable area nozzle through 1 or 2 spring nozzle. It needs separate water control valve, but we can provide it as package if necessary. With this solution, we have moderate cost and the rangeability remain up to 1 to 30. The rating remain up to NC 2500, and the maximum water capacity is 65 cubic meter to hour. The valve can be installed on a line size at least of 4 inch and higher, and the maximum water percentage respect the steam is up to 20%. The main feature of the Vary spring is to minimize the limitation of a fixed area types when the fluid velocity reduces to the flow rate decreases. This is obtained by automatically reducing the passage area when the flow rate decreases, so to maintain a fluid velocity consistent with the need of a good atomization. How it works? When the water pressure inside the nozzle tends increase over the set pressure of the spring, the water action on the plug exceeds and spring load and plug starts to open. The water starts to blow out from the nozzle flowing through the special drilling of the nozzle body, and the plug atomizes the water through a 90 degrees about shaped conical pattern. Spring load can be set to obtain the desired start opening pressure. The spring is loaded by the nut and keeps the plug in the closed position. The nut is locked by the pin to avoid any loosening. For an efficient superheating, the arrangement of installation is shown in this figure. A pressure control valve, as you know, is in this case needed, but we can supply it as a packet if it's necessary. We can have one only nozzle or with two nozzles as per the example picture here. Now let's see the variable wall mounted. It is a line type. It can be with piping connection, butt weld or flanged as standard. It is equipped with several wall mounted nozzles connected among the selvies, welded to an injection chamber. As you can see, the water is injected from a single inlet flange and sprayed out by the multiple nozzles disposed, placed separately along the pipeline. This configuration allows a higher percentage of water injection instead of the other Desuperheater series. This because the multiple nozzle spread with radial injections of cooling water that is more homogeneously along a greater surface of piping. And also, insert type Desuperheater, like the Variflow, may spray the same quantity of water into the steam piping, but not all the amount of injected water would evaporate. Variable needs a separate water control valve, but we can provide it as a package if it's necessary. It is used mainly for turbine bypass system, and it can inject a high percentage of water, up to 35%. The rangeability remain high, up to 1 to 25, and the rating remain up to 2500. It is installed directly in line, and the minimum size of the line is 8 inch. The water percentage respect the steam is very high and goes from 20% up to 35%. Here in this slide we can see two different configurations. On the right drawing, with 4 of 8 nozzle with the injection of water in one section, and on the left drawing with 4 or 8 nozzle with the injection of water in 2 sections. The third on the below drawing with 2 nozzle with the injection of water in 1 central section. Here an example of product with the main characteristic. The Desuperheater regulates the temperature from 210 to 155. On a 24 inch steam pipe. This is a DIF Varifix. It is a fixed area nozzle spraying device, single or multiple, with an excellent atomizing characteristic due to a sophisticated internal vortex ring, which ensures very small water drops sites at low differential pressure as well. They are primarily intended for applications where load is nearly constant, but moderate load fluctuations can be controlled due to the low rangeability, that is from 1 to 6. It also needs separate water control valve, but we can provide, as for the previous case, as package if necessary. These Varifix have a low cost respect to the other Desuperheaters, and it has the same Varispring body but with a fixed area nozzle. The rating remain up to 2500 with a maximum water capacity of 25 cubic meter to hour. The Varifix can be installed on a line size at least of 4 inch and higher, and the maximum water percentage respect the steam is up to 50%. For efficient superheating, the arrangement of installation is now shown in this figure. As you can see, we repeat that a pressure control valve is needed. So at the beginning we have the same control valve. After the superheater, the water control valve in the line, in the water line, And after we have the downstream steam pipe with the controlled temperature by the superheater. Here we have a picture of a vari fix. Now let's see vari spray. Vari spray nozzles are inline fixed area spraying devices which inject water in the outlet of a venturi shaped section combined with a drilling pattern of nozzle for an excellent and rapid atomizing of sprayed water. Low velocity steam flows can be truly handled as well with a minimum approach temperature of 6 Celsius degree over saturation. They are primarily intended for a very low capacity processes with moderate load changes and where an accurate temperature control is essential. The rangeability is up to 10 to 1. The rating is up to 600, lower respect to the other superheaters. And finally, the vari spray is installed directly in line and is designed small steam pipes. In fact, can be installed in size up to 4 inch. The maximum water percentage respect the steam is up to 50% with a maximum water capacity of 5 cubic meter to hour. Also in this case, for efficient superheating, the arrangement of installation is shown in this figure. So, as you can see, the vari spray is installed directly in line and a pressure control valve is needed, but we can supply it as a packet if it's necessary. As you can see, the nozzle of the vari spray consists of a venturi shaped section combined with a drilling pattern of nozzles. It produces an excellent and rapid atomizing of sprayed water. Now, another model that is the vari vent. That's at the superheater that is in line fixed area nozzles spraying device which inject water in the outlet of a venturi shaped section. The excellent and rapid atomizing of sprayed water is obtained through the combination of increased velocity of steam in the third section. It allows to have low differential pressure, water to steam, and low steam velocity. Low velocity steam flows can be truly handled as well with a minimum approach temperature of 5 degrees Celsius over the saturation. They are primarily intended for moderate load changes and where an accurate temperature control is essential. It also needs separate water control valve and is installed directly in line and is designed small steam pipes. In fact, can be installed in line size from 3 inch up to 16 inch. The maximum water percentage respect the steam is up to 20% with a maximum water capacity of 14 cubic meter to hour. In this slide you can see the a flow simulation of the steam velocity inside the vari vent and the turbulence after the injection point that improve the mixings of water and the steam that result in quick evaporation of water. For efficient the superheating, the arrangement of installation are shown in this figure. A pressure control valve also in this case is needed, but we can supply it as a package if it's necessary. In the above pictures, we can see the pathwell connection, can be also flanged connection, and in the also in this picture we can see in the drawing the easy maintenance because the nozzle of the superheater can be disassembled, maintaining the main body on the line. Here an example of a product with the main characteristic that the superheater regulates the temperature of the steam from 1350 to 176 Celsius degree on a 10-inch steam pipe. And the last one for cryogenic application is the VariCryo, that is similar to the VariFlow with a mainly characteristic and feature, but the main difference is the application, because instead of cooling water injection we have the liquid LNG. The body and the internal parts are all with stainless steel material due to the very low temperature of the process, up to -200 Celsius degrees. This is the most important application where the liquid into gas steam are required and are in the ship loading and unloading system. LNG liquid is injected into LNG gas supplied to fill up ship's tank. And also in the gas compressor stations, they injected LNG to adjust the gas temperature on the compressor section is at very low temperature. So now, way to make a recap, you can choose a VariFlow if you have many process condition, a VariSpring if you have some process condition, so moderate rangeability with a large amount of water. You can choose a VariFix if you have one predominant condition, a VariSpray if you have a small steam pipe, maximum up to 4 inch. You can choose a VariVent if you have a small differential pressure between water and steam or a low steam velocity. And finally, you can choose an MDIM if you have a very high percentage of water against the steam. Now it's really finished, so thank you very, very much for your attention. Thank you and bye bye.
Right, grazie Matteo. So thanks for sharing with us. And yeah, so as Casey said, so this dissipator actually suitable to use for the cryogenic application as well, because other than just spraying water to cool down or de-superheat the superheated steam, so you can also use to pump in the LNG. You can use to pump in the LNG, and then for the LNG transmissions. And also, yeah, just some Matteo also share some of few types of distributor that we have. Actually, all of them are actually to cater different application, and then according to the requirement and also the specification by the client and also on site. Yes. So okay. So maybe let's, since the time is almost up, then let's move to our quiz today. Yes, over here, that just now you guys has also been seeing this, so which is actually quite smaller compared to the equipment that stand beside me for the past 2 days. So here's my questions. So this thing, what it calls, and hold on. All the stallions don't need to answer first, so let me show this to you guys. So same as yesterday, so we shall play some a little bit, make it a little bit interesting for all of you. So please tell me the name of this component. So the, and then with a little TNC, is that the third and eighth correct answer will get the prize. So the prize today I will share, because since I share on the Grab technology yesterday, so for today I'll share on the touch and go cash voucher, which worth of 20 ringgits. So there will be two winners. And a little hint for you guys is that this thing is at the tip of the superheater, so it will be inserted into the pipeline and then it will spray water. So what this thing calls. Right. So the winner will be announced by our digital marketing later on. So stay tuned for who is the winner. And So actually, I guess I don't need to give so much to you since you guys have all the same answer from here. Okay, right. Then yeah. So I guess that's all for my session today. So I hope you guys enjoy learning and things of two about the product like pressure regulators or distributor for the past 3 days. And I'm your speaker today, Kelvin Tay. So thanks for joining us. I'll see you again. Thanks. Bye.